All right, guys, we got a new update for you today. How's everyone? I hope everyone is doing well. If you have not subscribed to the channel, please subscribe. If you don't know what's going on by looking at this map, you may need to go to some of my older videos so you can kind of get an update as to where we're at, how we got here, what we're doing, and what the goal is, and things of that nature. Let me first say something now. By doing these videos, guys, I'm aware that I put myself at a disadvantage at times because I allow people to see all my resources and stuff like that, and how I manage my resources and all those things. But I'm willing to do that in order to build a team that we can play more than just one map. You know, we could play other maps where we help each other and we fortify our skills and we get better. And you never know what that can turn into. So I just wanted to keep that in mind, is that I'm fully aware of some of the disadvantages I'll be at when I share a lot of information, especially on YouTube, because we got a lot of active players that visit my channel and they you know, they can learn a lot and can use it against me to further their goals. So let's take our time on this video. I want to take my time on it, and I want to kind of get into it and get into some of the details about where we're at and what we're planning on doing in the future. All right, so just take a second to just study the map, see what's going on. And well, you really can't see anything right now, but just study the map, see what we have occupied, see what we have left, and see just how everyone is mobilizing at this stage. So let's take a few seconds to do that. We'll start with Sydney. Sydney has made me aware that he's not going to be active every day, but he will be active. I'm sorry, now he won't be active as much, but he will be active at least twice a day. So, with that being said, he has an opportunity to really close this out. Right now, I will say that I'm being kind of generous with Sydney because technically we shouldn't have to wait to get this cleared out. As you can see, pretty much got everything else cleared out except for these two areas and these two. So Sydney, I would advise him to just get a little bit of a push on these areas because this is kind of holding us up from having the whole continent and just moving forward. So let's just take a little look at what's going on here, and we'll move forward. All right, now let's slide over here a bit. We were able to clear this area out here. As you can, we were able to clear this area out here. As you can see, Perth looks like he's going to come and go ahead and try to take this last province here, which I have no problem with. Only thing I would say about some of Perth's actions are, I think they're premature, and I think it's based on Perth is trying to advance and, you know, and just do the best he can to get as many provinces as he can so he can build his resources and things of that nature. So I have no problem with that. The only thing I see here is that when you're in a coalition, guys, it's very easy to step on someone else's toes. A general rule is that if I'm here and I'm already engaged in a province, technically, you know, you shouldn't get involved in that, if that makes any sense. Now, what I will do is I'm going to take a shot at this and I'm going to see something here. Ooh. Let's see. I want to see something, guys. Because right here, I have every right to try to get this province. He should not, I will say that Perth should not have moved that over there with my man standing right there. But at the same time, let the best man win. Whoever get that province, it won't really make a difference. But I just want to go ahead and take a stab at it to see what will happen when I engage this last troop here on that province. I want to see what will happen in that situation. Will I get the province or will Perth get the province? So it'll be a good learning moment for me to see who gets that province. Is it the man who engages in that battle first, or is it the man who actually killed the troop that will get that province? So that's going to be pretty interesting, and we'll keep an eye out on that. But again, I have no issues with Perth. I think Perth is playing a wonderful game. It's just some of Perth's actions, if I wasn't an experienced player, could have easily rubbed someone who's maybe not that experienced the wrong way. So let's go over here and see what Perth got going. And another thing I want to point out, same thing with Perth over here. I don't know why he's allowing these two AIs to sit here. I still have not figured that part out yet. But I will trust my teammate that he knows what he's doing. Maybe he's saving that for later. And I don't have no issue with that. Now, I think he would have an issue if I moved this guy over here and attempted to bother whatever that situation was. I think that would be part of what I mean by we don't want to rub each other the wrong way, you know. I want my guys to expand and get strong and to do what they need to do to further their goals. So we're all starting to head towards Malay here, Vietnam. I don't know if we're going to attack Vietnam, of course. We have to discuss that once we get all our troops together and once we close out these areas. So we have not gotten that far. So let's look at Port Macquarie. Port Macquarie really has not been that active in this game. And he's moved a whole lot of troops here, but didn't complete the mission of getting any real provinces in this area. So he's been sitting here for a while. So, not sure what to think about that. I'll send him a message and just kind of see where Port Macquarie head is at. I know Brisbane here has been moving his troops through, getting ready for our next mission. So I appreciate Brisbane staying active and waiting for his opportunity to expand. One thing about it, guys, just because you start off slow doesn't mean, I mean, this is really not a lot of provinces. So that's what I mean by Perth in this situation. It's like, this is going to be laughable, these type of situations, as we move forward. Because there's going to be so many provinces that you're going to have as we move forward that it's going to be even hard to manage them all. So you're not even going to be worried about a province from way back over here. We're going to be so far along than that. Oh wow, look at this, guys. Otoga has finally taken over the rest of those territories. So Otoga down here, he owns this entire area here. And it's possible that we may invite him to join the coalition. So that's a good look there, and we'll keep that in mind. Let's see here. So we talked about Port Macquarie. We talked about Brisbane. So that's what's going on there. I had to tell Perth once again, because he was sending a lot of troops to this area here. I had to tell Perth, I have this area under control. I pretty much set up a situation where if Dutch, South Dutch Papua, which is a member of my coalition, he has not been active. He hasn't sent me any messages. I've sent him a message asking him, is he still active? Really haven't gotten any information. So at this stage, we're looking at going ahead and confiscating these provinces. But you have to be very skilled and meticulous about how you want to do that. You don't want to bum rush and try to just take a bunch of stuff. You have to do it in a way that makes sense. So that's what we're looking at right now, guys. And right now, let me do this. Let's just get some guys in place so that when the time comes, we can go ahead and just handle our business. So let's move these guys over here. Okay. So the goal is definitely to take over this island here, like I always try to do. And that'll be a major operation and a major goal to try to achieve. And that will help me and the rest of my team move forward a lot stronger. Closing out some of these islands. Having fun over there with that. And that's pretty much where we're at right now, guys. There's not a whole lot going on. I do have Mindanao. He's here. He's taking over all of his provinces here, and he's moving towards Vietnam. All right, so that's where we're at right now, guys. Just wanted to give you guys a brief update. If you have not joined, if you have not subscribed, please subscribe. Ask any questions you may have. We haven't even gotten into some of the techniques, some of the tricks, airplane tricks. So many things that I'm gonna show you guys if you stay tuned and you pay attention to what's going on. You're gonna learn a whole lot hands on. Because in my opinion, I've mastered the game. There's not much I don't know about the game yet. So you'll get to see all those little things that you may not be aware of. So until next time, guys, stay tuned. And I look forward to sending you guys more videos and being more consistent with these videos. All right? So until next time, I'll see you guys later.